Yeah, yes, Chair, I will remove refusal of the application for the same principles that it was reviewed by the planning committee originally, which are contained in the two paragraphs at the top of page 45. To me, the valid reasons why it was originally refused are still valid reasons, and it's on that basis I would recommend refusal of this application.
Can I just say that obviously the first one was talking about proposed opening hours, and those hours have been reduced. I accept that you know, the residents still feel it might be a concern, but that point has been addressed where we've looked at reduced opening hours. And the alternative says something else.
Thank you, Chair. Just basically on the second reason for refusal, which is to do with effective sequential approach. That was refused because it was outside of the designated retail centre. The inspector, in his conclusions, has accepted that, given the small scale of the unit, it's defined, it's going to be for the mobile catchment. Customers wouldn't harm the viability of local centres, and so I'm not too convinced of that.
Okay, if you could just excuse us a moment, we just need to have some dialogue about this. Just bear with us a moment. The officers believe, based on the information they've got within the report, that would be summed up as appeal. So what I've asked the officers to do is to look at a different form of wording where they do believe it would stand up as appeal. So I'm going to ask the officers to read that, and then we can see if you'll move it again, Brian, and then we'll look for a second. Okay. Is that okay, Lindsay? Thank you.
Thank you. Sorry, Chair, not Chair, are we sort of not considering that one at the moment until they've decided to come up with some wording? Is that what we're trying to say?
I think the situation is that the wording proposed by the councillor, based on the full report that we've just been looking at, that would not stand up if it went to appeal. So what I've asked the officers to do is to look at a wording that would stand up as appeal in their opinion, and to offer those words to the councillor to consider instead.
So that will be done now this evening, and we'll vote on it later on this evening. Is that the intention?
Why can't you take the vote on what was proposed? I think I would all do with that. That's not right, that's not correct. You've got a recommendation.
Okay, what we'll do then is, based on what has been proposed, we've got Brian who said he's going to move it, we've got Ian who said that he would second that. So all those in favour of refusal, please raise your hand.
Chair, sorry, I'll withdraw my second.
Okay.
We need to put the microphone on.
I'm just
understand the issue that it may comply with number one and their policy which has been deemed. I still think there's an element of that that this does not comply with. It is predominantly in residential area. I don't believe that it does fully comply with community policies SH01, SH9 and SH10, which is the sequential test around the properties in the near vicinity that would be suitable for a convenience store. There is a number of convenience stores within the locality, so I'm not sure whether that would fall in line. I'm reading the documentation and I'm looking for why the refusal should be instead of proposed approval, and then I see there's some gaps in this.
Okay, so the situation is this. We have had a reasons for refusal from Councillor Kenny. We did have a seconder, which has now been withdrawn. So we need a seconder for Councillor Kenny. If we don't have a seconder, then we can move to a different amendment.
Okay, I will second.
Okay, so I'm sorry, Brian, we didn't have a seconder for your. So, does anybody else want to move refusal in respect to this?
I'll move refusal.
Okay.
On the grounds that I think it is an inappropriate development, it's in a residential area. It's not within the retail area, it's outside the retail area. So it doesn't comply with the rules of the policy of HS15. And I do think under in order to test the quality of the policy, SH01, SH9, SH10. I don't think it has met that sequential test regarding the potential premises that couldn't be suitable for a convenience store as opposed to one that's in a restaurant district, as opposed to one where there is a retail area around the corner.
Chair, I submitted a sequential test, and the AK says it's not referred to in the report.
I'm sorry, I can't ask you to be part of this debate. I need to discuss it with the officers and the legal team. I'm sorry, I can't accept your representation. Yeah.
Just to be helpful, Chair, what we're looking for, quite simply, is a specific, short, brief, concise wording that we're going to vote on.
Through you, Chair, to give advice on this to the committee to assist you in moving forward. The second reason for refusal, on the top of page 45, I would suggest that you do not want to use that as a reason for refusal in this case, because the inspector in his previous decision has said that a sequential test is not required because of the small scale nature of the proposal. So if committee are minded to refuse it still, then potentially there is something for you in the first reason for refusal at the top of page 45. As to whether or not you still think it's an inappropriate form, but I would advise against the insufficient evidence and sequential test in the approved set of reasons for refusal. So essentially I would suggest proposed use is considered inappropriate having regard to rules due to be policy HS15 as it's predominantly residential area and therefore detrimental to the amenities and adjoining occupiers, which will result in office evidence of nuisance and disturbance.
Okay, so our committee now clear on the words. Okay.
Yes.
So, Ron, are you happy to accept those words?
I'm happy to agree with them, Chair.
Okay, do we have a second to the that, please?
I'll second that, Chair.
Right, thank you, right. All those in favour of refusal?
Thank you.
now moving to agenda item...
Chair, before you move on, I apologise to you and the rest of the committee for losing control of my electronic devices. I absolutely am upsetting myself from the rest of the committee and protest not having the opportunity to listen to the rest of the applicant's presentation and contribution to the workers.
And it's quite right, I should listen to you. Okay, so agenda item 13, pages 65 to 17, your packs, if you can move to those, please. When you're ready, we can have a presentation.
Permission is sought for the erection of a new dwelling on the side island of 19 and Far Home Drive. The design of the proposal reflects the recently remodeled house dwelling at number 19, with upper floors contained.
Loading an egress driveway onto the right of way will result in the enlarged far end being visually hemmed in, and consequently will result in its visual street scope appearance being overdevelopment on its reduced site. This will be out of character with many of the other substantial detached family dwellings for which Far Hall Drive is renowned. I would like to draw your attention to the previous planning application for the main bungalow that was put in. It is the same owner, and he put a planning application in on the 16th of June 2017 for the redevelopment of the main bungalow, which has bearing on this. The description of the proposed works on question 3 of the application refers to the proposed remodelling of extension works to the existing bungalow, with no suggestion that an integral section of the contiguous amenity land was to be hived off for proposed residential development. Question 5 of the application relating to the pedestrian and vehicle access made no reference to intended charges or reductions in the existing separate access, separate egress facilities onto the bridle path. Question 8 of the application related to existing car parking range made no reference to intended changes or reductions in the plentiful amount of existing car parking on the site, which obviously will no longer be able to have that. Question 11 on our application refers to the proposed new double gates to each of the two existing driveways onto the bridle path. Basically, in the first application, there was provision for parking, provision to go off the bridle path and onto the bridle path by two separate gates that no longer now will exist with this second application that we've put in. So I feel that due to all this, the decisions that were made on the original plan has not been met, and has been changed by hiving this land off for the second proposal. The proposed development will reduce the separate vehicle access and egress points onto the bridle path, Far Hall Drive, from two established and well separate points, and result in them being used for both access and egress to each individual property. This reduction of separate access and egress to Far Hall End will result in a potential conflict with the joint access and egress drives of number 17 and 17A Far Hall Drive, located right opposite to the existing northern access entrance to Far Hall Drive. Far Hall Drive is a bridleway, and it's an unadopted road, which is mainly sandstone and pebble. So you can see why the proposals is causing a problem there. And it is right on the bend where the road narrows. And we see that there's actually a problem with the egress and access coming out over there, which a bridle path does take horses and so forth. The safety of the pedestrians, horse riders and others using the relatively narrow section of the bridle path is reduced by the consequent creation of two combined access egress points. The proposal will result in the loss of existing on-site provision of vehicle delivery to Far End and loss of on-site visitor car parking appropriate to the enlarged size and scale of Far End upon completion of the current expansion works to the original bungalow. The proposed development of the new dwelling fails to correctly respect the building line principle established in Far Hall Drive and is immediately adjacent to Rectory Lane, where in both instances residential dwellings are set back from the footpath in various depth to reflect the very different visual street scene appearance of the two respective roadways. The proposal fails to provide a continued approach of the established building line on the eastern side of Far Hall Drive, reflected by the modern development of two substantial family dwellings in Far Hall Drive, number 17 and 17A, with the established dwellings in Rectory Lane, number 38, and adjacent dwellings. Respectfully, there appears to be no reason and rationale to support the creation of a visual flaw in the established character of the visual street scene on either the western or eastern side of Far Hall Drive or Rectory Lane at this junction. The size, shape and suggested development site is materially smaller and thereby out of character with the other plots and dwellings in Far Hall Drive. The proposal gives the appearance of overdevelopment of this restricted size site, which is out of keeping with the general character of the individual dwellings and large plots in Far Hall Drive. The visual impact of the proposed dwellings, as illustrated in drawing B10, is out of scale with the immediate and adjacent properties in Far Hall Drive. It would create an incongruous plot on the established street scene, a large and spacious dwelling of larger